This is Mia King's exam mini video 3.2. In these images, we have a crossover event take place in an inversion loop. The image on the left is before the crossover, while the image on the right represents the four chromatids after the cross. These images allow one to see the crossover a little bit easier without taking into consideration the centromere or loci. In order to determine the chromatids, you need to know how to follow along with the line. In the top image, it is a simple line, so the chromatid is AMRZ. However, the bottom image displays a loop. To discover the chromatid, think about tracing the loop with your finger. If you start with E, you should trace the loop to get EFOT as the chromatid. These are simpler images to understand before looking at the full picture. This is individual 1 before the crossover event. To determine the setup and overlap the loci, the given chromosomes must be put in alphabetical order. Once this is done, we match up the similar loci to determine the type of aberration. In this case, the yellow represents loci in the same location. Therefore, loci M, L, H, and G will not be involved in the loop. For this example, it is a pericentric inversion because the inverted area includes the centromere. The period in the image represents the centromere. This is the resulting crossover event between loci J and K. The chromatids are color-coded to be able to visualize easier. The four resulting chromatids are displayed on the right. Here, only two chromatids are viable. The other chromatids have too many copies of one or more loci, therefore they are not viable. This is individual 2 before the crossover. Following the same steps seen with individual 1, we observe that these chromosomes are homozygous, therefore there will not be a loop. Here, we see the crossover between loci J and K. Unlike individual 1, this individual will produce 4 viable chromatids. They have also been color-coded here for an easier visual. Fitness is the ability to survive and reproduce. In regard to our individuals, individual 2 will have a higher expected fitness because all 4 chromatids are viable. Therefore, it has a 100% fitness. Individual 1 only has 2 viable chromatids, so it has a 50% fitness. These are the references used within this presentation.